Hello everyone, welcome to Life Around Science, and this is an interview of IIT JAM 2018 physics topper Air 1 Swarnim Shirke. Swarnim Shirke, a BSc graduate from Ferguson College Pune, secured rank 1 in IIT JAM Physics exam 2018. Although this topper has been a brilliant student throughout the academics, his success story has many twists and turns. Let's get to know him and get some actionable tips for IIT JAM exam. Hello Swarnim, tell us something about you.
Hello. Born and brought up in Pune, I completed my schooling here at SPM English School, after which I took admission to Ferguson Junior College Pune, where I opted for bifocal subjects. My subjects were PCM and Computer Science, replacing Biology. My first year BSc subject combination was Physics, Mathematics, Statistics, Electronics, which was just perfect for me. All were related to physics, and it was offered in the BSc course at Ferguson Senior College, Pune. In second year, I kept Physics, Maths, Stats, and the third year was just pure Physics, which would be my major.
You have secured JAM Air 1 and JEST Air 15. How did you prepare?
The thing is, I never prepared specifically for any exam. The only thing that was and still is in my mind is to understand and know physics as good as I can. I took my coursework seriously. I referred to reference books for the concepts that I felt I didn't understand completely. Also, even though I fairly knew that I would do a physics major, I gave other subjects, maths, stats, and electronics, an equal importance. This helped me a lot because I started feeling the power of these mathematical and statistical tools later in physics and didn't have to struggle much with them later. They are extensively used in physics, by the way. I would take any co-curricular exams that came my way to probe myself, find the weak areas, practice problem solving, and just stay in touch with different subjects. Although I didn't take these exams very seriously, the key ingredient I would say has been consistency. Learning just a tiny bit, but every day, yields lots of results.
JAM or JEST, which is better?
I like JAM questions more, as they involve more of conceptual understanding rather than long sets of calculations. However, it doesn't matter, since the set of institutes accepting the scores of these exams are different, except for a few ICERs. So it depends on where you would like to apply.
How should JAM aspirants study to crack JAM?
I feel the following points should help. 1. First, go through JAM syllabus so you know what you're supposed to know by the time you are graduated. 2. Do the BSc coursework thoroughly. Make sure you understand all concepts in and out, along with the concepts of 11th and 12th grade. 3. Solve a few question papers so you get an idea about the exam. Some highlights would be, study the topics that are in syllabus but not covered in your coursework from other sources like reference book, internet, interaction with other people, other available material, etc. Solve problems in general. If you can't, read solutions and try to understand them so that you develop problem solving skills and know more tricks to save time. These are not a must. They are subject to one's interest and availability of time. As I mentioned before, the key ingredient is consistency. Learning something just a bit but every day gives a compounding effect. It even builds subject confidence because what you're doing is very little, hence you feel it is doable. You can just mug up in one day, but you cannot understand and know the essence of so many topics in just a day. Furthermore, if you're not consistent, you lose track and there is a chance that you might lose interest in your subject altogether, which is the fuel that drives you in the first place. The real fun is in knowing the subject better. If you're enjoying what you're doing, what you're studying, then you're going right. Knowledge is what will take one ahead at the end of the day. So keep learning and enjoying, and then not only will you crack all the exams, but also everything else will fall right in place in your favor.
Most of the students are focused on cracking JAM only, but you prepared a list of examinations and cracked most of these. Please share some details.
There are several exams for which BSc final year students can appear. I would assume that students focusing on cracking JAM are interested in science and want to pursue the same ahead. I am specifying the ones that I appeared in. IIT JAM. This is a postgraduate level entrance examination where I secured AIR1. In general, all IITs, NITs, IISc, some centrally funded technical institutes and ISERs accept JAM score. From these institutions, I applied and got selected at IIT Bombay and ISER Pune. This year, applications started around in September and the exam was held in February. JEST, Joint Entrance Screening Test. This is an MSc level exam where I secured rank 15. There are a number of lists of institutions which accept JEST score, which are available online on JEST website. From these institutions, I applied to and got selected at TIFR Mumbai and ICTS TIFR Bangalore through this exam. To my knowledge, almost all of these research institutes offer only integrated PhD and PhD courses. This year, application started around in December and the exam was held in February. INAT, IUCAA NCRA Admission Test. This is entrance exam for those who want to pursue astronomy and astrophysics at IUCAA or NCRA TIFR research institutes in Pune. Note that you don't need a background of astro. The questions are based purely on physics and mathematics. I got selected for integrated PhD at NCRA and pre-selected for PhD at IUCAA, which are the two courses you can get selected for. This year, applications started around in September and the exam was held in December. TIFR-GS. This is an entrance exam conducted by TIFR for admission to TIFR Mumbai, NCRA Pune, ICTS Bangalore, which are various schools of prestigious TIFR Public Research Institute. Although I cleared this exam, I didn't apply anywhere through it. This year, applications started around in October and the exam was held in December.
Where will you take admission now? What are your future plans?
Right now, I think MSc would be the right option for me. This would keep things flexible for me, and also I don't want to rush with the theory in an integrated PhD course. And MSc would let me build a proper physics base, so I'm joining IIT Bombay. I usually don't plan the future, which is one of the reasons I prefer MSc over an integrated PhD. It is like deciding fate. I'll eventually find out my future and what it holds for me. The fun is in exploring and keeping all possibilities open. Something that one believes would be the best for him or her may not really be. I happen to shrug away from any long-term plans, although it has some other benefits like getting an edge over others. Although I can tell right now that I am enjoying physics and hence MSc. The same goes as far as the field of physics is concerned. I like astronomy and astrophysics from the exposure I have right now, since it really includes all the topics of physics. But there is still time for me to explore different fields and to find out which field I really want to get in. And MSc would help me do so. There are so many fields in physics that by fixing upon one right now would deprive me of many other opportunities. It is like you are going to a whole chocolate factory, fixing beforehand that you'd have an eclair toffee over there.
Why not abroad?
Indian institutes seem quite good, at least for an MSc. It is speculation that most of the top rankers get admitted to various top institutes in India itself, even though they can easily get into institutes abroad. Although it is clearly tougher to get an admission here than abroad, as one has to clear these tough exams and interviews to get admission and interviews. So unless we are talking about pioneer universities in the world like Cambridge, it doesn't seem worth. There is no need to emphasize that IIT Bombay is very well known all over the world, so I don't really think I'm missing out on anything.
Every year, nearly 13,000 students appear in JAM Physics. Do you think physics is a great career option for a research career?
Yes, I do think so. It is probably one of the best fields for research. The reason for this is that physics is a very huge field in itself and has wide applications. For example, it includes astronomy and astrophysics, biophysics, condensed matter physics, high energy physics, photonics, quantum computation, nonlinear physics, theoretical physics like gravitation, cosmology, string theory, etc., etc., just to name a few. It is also wide in the sense that it covers the study of objects right from the smallest scales like strings, which are 10 raised to minus 35 meters in string theory, and quarks, to the largest scales like galaxies and entire universe, which is about 10 to the power 26 meters. Another reason is that there are lots of institutes and research centers, not just in India, but all over the world, which aggressively focus on physics. This emphasizes the ocean of opportunities available and signifies the importance of physics.
What intrigues you most about physics?
The fact that it has tremendous predicting power. It is a subject which uses the language of mathematics, which is the nature's language, the most precise one, to model and explain simply nature and the universe. It is a science which quantifies and predicts precisely the future based on the most fundamental cosmic laws appearing in their purest and rawest form. But nothing is perfect. There are always errors and variations in everything. Here, physics uses statistics, again quantifies precisely the randomness of our mother nature. And it all works. One can rather just sit here on Earth and put an object in an orbit around the entire Earth or the Sun. That too, knowing beforehand what trajectory it would follow in the following years.
Any resources or helpful notes that you would like to recommend to other JAM aspirants?
Nothing specific as such. Books have been previously solved papers and extra test papers could be useful at later stages. Referring to standard reference books for each subject would help. Which people usually do. Do not use reference books as textbooks. Use them only to understand the concepts that you need to know. The following are the ones I like in general because of their lucid language. One is Concepts of Physics by H.C. Verma. Another is Introduction to Mathematical Methods in Physics by Mary L. Bose. One more is Introduction to Electrodynamics by David J. Griffiths.
Is it possible to crack IIT JAM Physics without coaching? What's your take on classroom teaching?
A big yes. This is a very popular question trending now, but people don't find any live example of it. So I guess the case of JAM Air 1 should be convincing enough because the result can't get better than this. I have never joined any tuition or coaching for any studies in my entire life. I have been consistently scoring above 95% throughout my academics. I have cleared all major entrance exams like JAM, JEST, TIFR, INAT, ACET, which is for actuarial sciences, and other exams like NGP, National Graduate Physics Exam, Madhava Maths Competition, Pune University Statistics Quiz, Electronics Excellence Exam, etc. without any coaching. So yes, it is possible. It is you, the most precious ingredient in any journey. In the case of IIT JAM Physics, all you need is the syllabus, good material to study from, and your desire to understand physics. The more you invest in knowledge, the better it gets. Rather than joining coaching classes, it is better to self-study, which you anyway have to do in either case. You free up a lot of time by not joining one. Also, doing this classroom coaching apart from your regular college classes might just burn you out. Most of the students who join classes just require guidance and a proper material, not coaching. They end up spending time, efforts, and money on something they don't even need. You don't you don't even need to go overboard and study extra. Another example of clearing JAM without any coaching is my sister, whose AIR was under 200. Sticking to the regular college curriculum thoroughly as she did works. You started focusing on physics in your third year of BSc lately. Imagine what you can do if you have already decided it way before.
How do you keep yourself motivated?
I have two lines to say for this. If you're doing something where you need to keep yourself motivated, you're probably doing the wrong thing. And second, do what you love, love what you do. This, I believe, plays a very important role in the long run. Artificial or external motivation only works on short time scales and might lead you to an incorrect path.
How did you decide your career path?
I personally think it is too early to choose a career path after 12th standard, just like choosing a stream in 10th standard. What I have seen and experienced is that very few really know what they really want to do or what they really like, and most of the students are just following the mass, following the deceptive trend. There are so many options other that we have never even seen. On contrary to the popular trend, I have never applied for JEE exam or any other. This let me explore what I liked with an open mind. I had no idea what to pursue ahead. I had varied interests like football, learning new languages, traveling, apart from this, etc. It was at the end of 12th standard when I started to feel that I liked physics. I think it is very difficult to decide a career path very early. It was a big problem for me, so I thought I'd stick to physics as career path and continue with other interests as hobbies. Given that, 3-year BSc was the obvious choice, which let me study physics in its purest form.
What are the other activities that you enjoy?
One word, football. I play football regularly. I love it. I like sports in general and I've played a variety of them, but football is the one that remained there. My other interests include learning new languages, traveling, music, etc.
To whom do you owe your success?
Most of the credit goes to my family. I credit them for my success and I have various reasons for maintaining a conducive environment for studying, as well as for other activities like sports, for making me aware of different opportunities, possibilities and options, for having an open mind and encouraging me to do so, for helping me in my decision making, etc. I don't think I'd be in this position right now without all of this. Taking very specifically about the physics subject matter, I would say my college, its faculty and consistency played an important role. I wouldn't call getting the rank 1 a success, so I firmly believe that getting good marks and rank is not what success is. Talking from a student point of view, one is successful when one understands his subjects and gains confidence regardless of the marks and the rank. Every time a student expands his knowledge, he's successful. So getting a rank 1 by just formulas or tricks without actually having understood the concepts behind everything wouldn't really count as a success.
Thank you, Swarnim. It was great to know about your views. I'm sure this interview will be helpful to other students, and I wish you luck in all your future endeavors. We'll be right back.